الله الرحمن الرحيم، الملك القدوس السلام، المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار. الله الرحمن الرحيم، الملك القدوس السلام، المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to this episode on the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this episode, we are going to talk about his name Al-Shaheed, the witness, and later Al-Haqq, the truth. First, Al-Shaheed, which is of course coming from the Arabic word Shahida, to witness a thing, to be present anywhere where you can see something and then you report it back, and then it becomes Shahada or a testimony. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness that he sees everything, he notices everything, he is a witness to everything. And in the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would raise the people as a witness as well, not only in this world but also in the hereafter, as he said about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَىٰ هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا, and we are going to bring you a witness upon them. Now this word Al-Shaheed is mentioned 18 times in Al-Quran. We are not going to cover all those places, but let us mention few of them. For example, in the end of Surah Al-Ma'idah, the saying of Isa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him this question, that did you say to the people to declare you yourself and your mother as two gods? This we have already mentioned in our discussion about another attribute of Allah. But anyhow, the word is used here, وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٌ. Twice it has been mentioned here. That is the reply of Isa alayhi salam. He would say to Allah that I was just a witness to them as long as I lived among them. When you have taken me to the heaven, kunta anta raqiba alayhim, you were watchful upon them, wa anta ala kulli shay'in shaheed, and you are a witness upon everything. So this is the word which makes the matter very clear. Isa alayhi salam is saying that I can only give my testimony as for that period when I was living among them, whether it was during my first coming or in the second coming. I can't take responsibility of any other period in which I was not present there. Another ayah of Surah Al-An'am, قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةً قُلِ اللَّهُ شَهِيدٌ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ. Say, what is the biggest testimony? Say, Allah is a witness between us and yourselves. So the best testimony is the testimony of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the testimony about Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is none to be worshipped except Him. And then in Surah Al-Hajj, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Indeed, Allah is going to judge among them on the Day of Judgment. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness upon everything. And then in Surah Al-Mujadilah, أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got the record of everything. He has counted them all. They forgot Him. He did not forget them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness upon everything. And then the ayah of Surah Al-Nisa, لكن الله يشهد بما أنزل إليك أنزله بعلمه والملائكة يشهدون وكفى بالله شهيدا. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a testimony of what He has revealed unto you. He has revealed it with His knowledge. And the angels give that testimony. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Just the testimony of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough. And also this ayah, قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough as a witness among ourselves and yourselves. Indeed, He is well aware of His people. So, in that way, we can say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is a witness upon our actions, and He is a witness upon His tawheed. شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. That testimony of the tawheed of Allah, the oneness of Allah, first comes from Allah Himself. He has given this testimony that there is none to be worshipped except Him. And this testimony is coming from the angels. It is coming from the people of the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stands with justice. There is none to be worshipped except Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Shaheed. And it also implies that He is Alim. He got the knowledge. He got the knowledge of everything. And let us remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised us as the ummah, witness for this deen. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He has raised you as a balanced ummah so that you become witness upon the people, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a witness upon you. And that is the impression of this attribute in our lives. He is Shaheed, and we become Shaheed for His deen. Now let us move to the other attribute of Allah, Al-Haqq, the truths, the absolute truths, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are things about which you can't have any doubt. Even a non-believer can't have any doubt about the death. This is why it is said, Al-Mawtu Haqqun. Mawt is Haqq. And Haqq means the thing which is going to happen. And also Al-Haqq, the one about which there is no doubt at all. And that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever He created, that is Haqq as well. And this is why one of the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he used to say, Allahumma lakal hamd, anta rabbus samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. Allah, you are Haqq, to you belong all the praise in the heaven, in the earth, and in between them. Allahumma lakal hamd, anta qayyumus samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are Haqq, and you are the maintainer, the caretaker of the heaven and the earth, and whatever in it. Al-Haqq, wa qawluka haqq, wa wa'duka haqq, wa liqa'uka haqq, wal jannatu haqq, wal naru haqq, wal sa'atu haqq. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are Haqq, you are the truth, your saying is truth, your promise is truth, meeting you on the day of judgment is truth. The paradise is truth. The hellfire is truth. The last day is truth. Allahumma laka aslamtu wa alayka tawakkalt. O Allah, to you I submit myself. O Allah, upon you I trust. Wa ilayka anabtu wa bika khasamt. And to you I turn, and with you I argue. Wa ilayka hakamt. And to you I raise my matter to you for judgment. فَغْفِرْ لِي مَا قَدَّمْتُ وَمَا أَخَّرْتُ. O Allah, forgive me for all what I have advanced, what I have left behind. وَمَا أَسْرَرْتُ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُ. What I have hidden and what I have exposed. أَنْتَ إِلَهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. You are my God. There is none to be worshipped except you. That was the dua of the Prophet ﷺ at night time. Now let us see some of the ayat. It has been mentioned 10 times in the Quran, the word al-haq. Some of the ayat, ثُمَّ رُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مَوْلَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ أَلَا لَهُ الْحُكْمُ وَهُوَ أَسْرَعُ الْحَاسِبِينَ. That is in Surah Al-An'am. Then they are going to be returned back to their Lord, who is haq. To him belongs the judgment, and he is the one very swift in his reckoning. هُنَالِكَ تَبْلُو كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا أَصْلَفَتْ وَرُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مَوْلَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ وَظَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. At that day, every nafs is going to put herself to trial for all what it has done. وَرُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مَوْلَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ. And they would be returned to their Mawla, to their master, who is haq, who is truth, absolute truth. وَظَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. And all what they have been fabricating before is going to be lost. And then the ayah of Surah Al-Kahf, هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ وَخَيْرٌ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أُقْبَى. That was in the parable of the person who got, the two persons who were arguing with each other, the person with a lot of orchards and gardens, and he thought that he is not going to be resurrected. And the other person who was a believer, and telling him, have faith in Allah, because all these things which are now, you own them, they are not going to last. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, your orchard, your gardens may be struck with a thunderbolt and they are going to be destroyed completely. And this is what happened to him. And in the end comes this ayah, هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ هُوَ خَيْرٌ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أُقْبَى. The authority is there for Allah, who is haq, and he is better to give a reward and better for your end. And then the ayah, which is ayah of Surah Al-Hajj, ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل وأن الله هو العلي الكبير. This is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is haq. He is the truth. And whatever they invoke other than Allah is al-batil, is falsehood. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exalted. He is great. Then the ayah of Surah Al-Mu'mineen, المؤمنون فتعالى الله الملك الحق لا إله إلا هو رب العرش الكريم. Exalted is he, Allah, the King, the truth. There is none to be worshipped except him, and he is the master of the noble throne. And then that ayah of Surah An-Nur, يومئذ يوفيهم الله دينهم الحق وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ. That day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to pay them all what they have done, reward or punishment. وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ الْمُبِينَ. And they would know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the manifest truth. He is the truth, the absolute truth. So Allah is haq, and whatever he has created is haq. And inshallah, we are going to continue after the break as well. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, al-Malik al-Quddus al-Salam, al-Mu'min al-Muhaymin al-Aziz al-Jabbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now in this episode we are going to talk about the two attributes which come together. Al-Qawi, the strong. Al-Mateen, the firm. Al-Qawi, the most strong, which is coming from Al-Quwwah, which is the strength, and which implies the dominance, the authority. Let us take the ayah of Surah Al-Dhariyat, in which these two attributes are mentioned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. This ayah is a very beautiful ayah, giving the objective of the mankind. Because many people, they say that the objective of the Muslim Ummah is this and that. But that objective is very clearly given in this ayah. It is for the whole mankind. I did not create the jinn and the human being except to worship me. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُتْعِمُونَ. I am not asking from them any sustenance. I am not asking them to feed me, because إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Indeed, Allah is the one who sustains, and he is the one with power, al-mateen, with very firm power. So al-quwa with al-matana, they are put together, they increases each other in strength, and that is the beauty of these two attributes. This is why they have come together. Now this word al-qawi, sometime it is mentioned with al-aziz, and not in one ayah, in more than one ayah. For example, Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha wa huwa al-qawiyyul aziz. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very, very gentle with his people. And when we have discussed this attribute of Allah, al-latif, we have said at that time that latif means subtle. Latif also means gentle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very gentle with his people. يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He gives the sustenance whom he likes. وَهُوَ الْقَوِيُّ الْعَزِيزُ. And he is strong, he is dominant. That is the ayah of Surah Al-Shura. Another ayah from Surah Al-Hijr. مَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. They did not recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as they should have recognized him. They did not know about his qadr, about his dignity, about his status. Means the mushrikeen people, the infidel, the kuffar people, they did not recognize who is Allah, how great he is. And they should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is qawi, is strong. Aziz, he is dominant. And then the ayah of Surah Al-Hajj. وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to help those who help him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is strong, is dominant. Again, this ayah gives another clue here, that if you are hoping for the victory of Allah, how you can get that victory? Help Allah. Means help the deen of Allah, the way of Allah. Help the Quran of Allah. If you stand by the deen of Allah, he will stand by you. When you stand by Islam, he is going to help you. That is the promise which is made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah. And then the ayah of Surah Al-Hadid. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ وأنزلنا الحديد فيه بأس شديد ومنافع للناس وليعلم الله من ينصره ورسله بالغيب إن الله قوي عزيز. And we have sent our messengers with clear evidences, and we have revealed with them the book and the balance. The book and the balance, that balance is Sharia, which is taken from the book itself, so that people لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. The people stand with justice. وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ. And then we have brought down the iron, and in the iron there is a lot of strength. وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ, and lot of benefits for the people. وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows who is going to help Allah and His messengers. بِالْغَيْبِ, being unseen. Without seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is dependent upon the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He got such a great dependence that he always helped the messengers and the prophets even without seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌ عَزِيزٌ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is qawi, is strong, He is dominant. And we said about the second attribute of Allah, Al-Mateen, that this is giving an extra strength to the word Al-Qawi. So this is why when we speak about these two attributes, we have to take them together. Take another ayah, which is the ayah of Surah Al-Mujadila as well. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌ عَزِيزٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has recorded that I am going to be dominant and my messengers. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is strong, is dominant. And we have said it in these lessons many times that there is a difference between the status of a messenger and the status of a prophet. The status of messenger is a bit higher than the status of the prophet, because there is a promise which is given to the messenger, not to the prophet. What is that promise? كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي. That is al-ghalaba. That is the dominance. So the messengers of Allah are going to be dominant. They are not going to be defeated, let alone be killed. So this is why in Al-Quran, where we read about the killing, that is the killing of the Prophet. يَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ. It is said about the Israelites that they used to kill the prophets without any justice at all. يَقْتُلُونَ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. They used to kill the prophets بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ, without any haqq at all. And this what happened to Zakariya alayhi salam. He was killed, martyred. It happened to his son Yahya alayhi salam. He was martyred as well. But when it comes to Isa alayhi salam, who is the messenger of Allah, because he is the messenger of Allah, he can't be killed. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. They did not kill him. They did not crucify him. But someone of his resemblance was taken and who was killed. Here there is another interesting note in this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned both things. They did not kill him, they did not crucify him. To show that Isa alayhi salam was not killed, because the death can come in any way. But this specific death which they assume that he was crucified, he was taken to the cross. No, it did not happen. It did not happen at all. So Isa alayhi salam, as a messenger of Allah, this was the promise of Allah that he would be dominant, like the all other messengers of Allah in the past. And because Isa alayhi salam was not shown to be dominant in his first coming, this is why he has to come once again. And when he would come once again, he would get this dominance by killing the Antichrist, Ad-Dajjal. He would kill Ad-Dajjal. He would be supported by all the believers. And also those people who believed in Isa alayhi salam before wrongly, now they will believe him as a prophet of Allah, as a messenger of Allah. So this is about that ghalaba and authority which is given to the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with this word al-mateen, we got another understanding of the words, that The strength of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to last forever. It is perpetual. It is everlasting. It is not going to come to an end. So that is the extra meaning which we can understand from the word al-mateen when it is associated with al-quwa. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes the people who disobey him, and he has punished them in the past. Sometimes the forces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were implied, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said very, very clearly that if he wanted to punish someone, he does not need those forces at all. It would be just a cry, a big cry, like a thunderbolt, and then the people are going to die because of that. That is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let the people be destroyed without applying any force at all. Now, what should be the impression of this attribute in our lives? As long as we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is strong and all the sources of strength lie with him, then we should turn back to him in our prayers, in our supplications. Even if we are weak, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is strong. So, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the moments of your weakness and also in the moments of your strength. Always turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the attitude of a believer, that whether he is in the state of as-sarra, yani in player, or in the state of ad-dharra, that is in difficulty. In both circumstances, he turns back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he is enjoying the bounties of Allah. He is enjoying the wealth. He is enjoying a sound health. He does not forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the very same way, if he is in poverty, if he is surrounded with worries, he does not forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This should be the impression of these two attributes, Al-Qawi and Al-Mateen, in our life. And with this, we come to the end of this session. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu ar-Rahmanu ar-Rahim, Al-Malik al-Quddus al-Salam, Al-Mu'min al-Muhaymin al-Aziz al-Jabbar. Allahu ar-Rahmanu ar-Rahim, Al-Malik al-Quddus al-Salam, المؤمن المهيمن العزيز.